Hello, all greetings. This is Gilles Mancillon, beloved family, human family. I wanted to come briefly today to comment on the energies that are very, very shaking the whole world. Everything has been shaking off, everything shaked up. It is like a great death and rebirth. It is a deconstruction and reconstruction. Everything has been moved and changed and transformed. Of course, the facade, the outer world, the physical world will be the last affected. But first, the change has to happen within. And the more we trust that which is going on, the easier things will flow. So it is important to continue with this process, continue with this trust, and to know that, of course, we have ups and downs. There will be easy days, hard days, but in essence, that the more difficulty we have within our mental, emotional process, the more we know that we are moving towards something better because we are releasing all those old patterns that have been stuck with us for quite a long time on a cellular level. Of course, it is important to continue to develop our compassion, to love others, to love ourselves, to develop our lucidity, to meditate and to allow this light to unfold within us, and also to develop our courage, the courage to perfect our character, to look at our mistakes in order to correct them and do what we can, although to live in acceptance of who we are, yet to always be attentive to those things that life can reflect us, that can, because the mistake is never someone else. It's, we always have to seek the mistake within ourselves, because that is where we are able to make the adjustment. For the Buddha knew that. One of the magic power he discovered is to establish himself in lucidity and serenity before he could attain nirvana. But in order to do that, he had to fix all the past mistakes. And from there, he was completely free. For the Buddha is a very powerful force, an immortal force that is right now, at the time of Vesak, enveloping the world. The Buddha has taken new responsibility in relationship to this ascension, but all ascended masters, all angels, archangels, galactic families, all the groups, five group families, such as the Egyptian gods or the Olympians or any other sort of immortal entities or the great gods of all creation, such as Jehovah or Allah or the Paradise Father, the Paradise Trinity, all those beings are connection so that we may. That helps us connect to our soul. As our soul moves towards that, we will eventually be able to fuse our consciousness with that eternal force of love and wisdom. For we have this amazing presence, the spirit presence of the universal Father himself, that has fractioned himself as a pre-personal person. God fragments himself as a person he creates, and as a super person he eventuates. Well, those things will be discussed later on, but for now, to know that we have this amazing presence of God within ourselves, and that is what we seek to do. It is so the will of God may be done, not my own will, but the will of God. I will to wills I will. So that is really what's very important to understand and to work with each and every day to allow this love to bloom, to grow, to unfold, to. And so it is also. It is also important to use mantras, no matter what the circumstances are, to remind you. To say to yourself, I am love, I am light, I am peace, I am joy, I am compassion, I am the truth of who I am, the highest truth of who I am. I am the extension of Source that is equal to Source. And so, the more when you say I am, you anchor those energy within yourself, and you repeat that to yourself so that until the harmony, say I am harmony. And so whenever there is chaos, if you can reap chaos or whatever, because as we move into this new energy, all kinds of all belief system and system of functioning are being disassembled and put in question. So it is important to bring them back into harmony by repeating to yourself, by knowing that you are peace, you are love, you are light, you are the highest expression of who you are. And slowly but surely, those things are anchoring within yourself, and we are moving towards a greater realization in relationship to our aspiration, of course, and our beliefs. I just wanted to come and make this brief message to send blessings, but do not forget to bless yourself. It is important to not wait. As you said, namaste, you awaken your own presence within yourself. As you said, I am love, you awaken the love within yourself. So and then you can also awaken within other people as well. But your true responsibility is your own ascension, and as you do that, you will find a natural way of serving, natural way of helping, natural way of assisting others in their own unfoldment of spiritual essence and power. For we are been all kinds of amazing power are being returned to us, and new powers will be given as well, as we are allowing to all to let go of all those limiting beliefs, all those toxins, all those bad habits, all kinds of things. So we have to go slowly but surely, and all things in moderation, for life is always harmonizing, balancing out. But we do want to move forward, we do not want to move backwards, for time does not exist, everything has been erased. It's only the now that is truly where the future is being created, is within the now. So as we create a positive expectation within the now, we have more chances to manifest that in a graceful fashion, so to speak. I'm going to pull a few cards to see what the highest wisdom for us today is. The higher self. The higher self is really what we want to connect with. It is really what we want to integrate. We have more than one higher self, but in essence, it is this larger energetic consciousness, vibration, field of energy that we need to integrate and through our soul to bring all those parts of ourselves together, and that is coming progressively, of course. What we need to do is karma. For karma is very much what is we're experiencing, is all those whatever chaotic or limiting beliefs are our karma. We have created that. We have believed in those things, and so we have made them real. As we believe, we make things real. And so we have to accept our karma, to be grateful for our karma, and from there we can transcend this karma and be free of it. What we need to do is transformation, to allow the transformation to be integrated within ourselves and to allow the process to happen naturally. And the general message for us, the same thing than the French reading, it is responsibility. The more power we have, the more responsibility we have. So it is about understanding why we here, what is our past, why did we come here, what is our function within the earth, and assume the responsibility that that will allow us to move into greater fulfillment, greater expansion, greater sense of self in many ways. So I hope this message was interesting for you. I wanted to read a little poem. It's a poem that inspired my very, very first painting. I was living in November 1989. I was living in Los Angeles. And this was my first major painting. I will put it in the little vignette. It was on a bed sheet. It was 2 meters by 2 meters and a half. And it's a poem that greatly inspired me. It's called Divine Love. Goes like this. I come to you again today overwhelmed by an intense affection, and what I have for you is my love that I cannot fully express, because the limitation of language in which no word can nearly convey the true effusion of my heart. My beloved children, I am love, and love is me. My love is a perpetual fountain that flows and inundates the cosmos, pervading all living creatures and all paths of life. It manifests itself in adversity, pulsates in every breath of the living cell of the cosmos, and vibrates in the living soul of the world. It can be said that my love knows no limit, no bond. Only those who grasp the truth can experience its presence, which embraces and transcends all times and all spaces. Well, thank you very much. I'm going to finish with a little song. It's a song I already sang, but it's been coming through my head, so I'll sing it again. It's about a meeting with an angel and the ability to know that once we connect to our invisible forces and helpers, we connect to that eternal part of ourselves, the eternal well-being. And so it is very essential to tune in to that inner self and to develop, to cultivate that connection day after day. It's a song called Angel. It was like this. Angel came down from heaven yesterday. She stayed with me long enough to rescue me. And she told me a story yesterday about the love between the moon and the deep blue sea. And when it was time for her to go, she spread a wing high over me. And she said, I shall return tomorrow. And I say, fly on, my sweet angel. Fly on through the sky. Fly on, my sweet angel. Tomorrow I will feel you by my side. And sure enough, this morning comes to me. Where silver wings silhouette against the glow of a child's sunrise. And as the bluebirds and sparrows envy me, she says, I love you, little boy, and today you shall fly. She kissed me once, and the feeling so good she made me cry. And now we'll fly together. And I say, fly on, my sweet angel. Fly on through the sky. Fly on, my sweet angel. Together we shall always be alive. Well, thank you very much. I wish you a wonderful day, and I'll talk to you later. Namaste.